Welcome back, Christopher Isaac here, and in this segment, we're going to be talking about men. And if you're tired of them, here's four things you need to do about it. But before I tell you those four steps, here's the psychology of why men are, well, men. Men are more often than not driven by ego. They want to feel more like a man to the woman that they want to attract. This can sometimes cause them to do crazy things. Things like be needy, be standoffish, text too much, text too little, send unprovoked images of their excitement for you. Overcompensate. Hell, you name it. Men can do some crazy shit in the name of their ego. So, here are the four steps you need to take to attract the right man with the full confidence that you are not at all wasting your time. Number one, stop looking for relationships. See, when you're constantly looking for a partner, you have this lens of the world, the way that things should be, how men should behave. This lens will cause you to have expectations that will ultimately leave you dissatisfied, or worse, completely jaded. But secretly, you and I both know that you just want a guy who has his shit together and knows how to be secure with himself. So, number two, now that you've stopped looking for relationships, number two is make friends. When you stop looking for relationships and you just start making friends with everyone you meet, this fundamentally changes your worldview of how men should operate. You're not looking for the right guy. The pressure's gone for you and everyone else. It fundamentally changes how you think men should operate because you're not looking for a relationship, you're just looking to hang out with people that you vibe well with, which, to be honest with you, is the foundation you need to have when looking for a partner. I mean, think about it. Let's just say you have a 7-day trip to go on a cruise in the Bahamas. Are you gonna pick anyone to go with you, or are you gonna be really confident that the person you choose to go with you, you can vibe with for 7 days? My guess is you're probably gonna be really selective about that person, and you're gonna wanna make sure that you vibe with this human being. Now, when you're looking for a partner, it's that, but for the rest of your life. Which leads me to number three. Set standards for your friends. Set standards for all of your friends, actually. You should always do this, male or female. Set standards for how people should treat you, how they should behave, and here's why you should do this. You see, men are usually just doing the best they can, or they're just convinced that their way of attracting women works. But not all men are like that, and not all women are attracted to the same thing, or the same sort of attention for that matter. Now, I've interviewed past students who have worked with me, students who say that they're in the best relationship they've ever been in, and some that are even now married, and the universal response that I get from all of them is that yes, one man can teach you that not all men are the same. So, you stop looking for relationships, you're just looking to make friends with people, and now you're gonna set standards. The way to set standards is to communicate what you do like and what you don't like in normal conversation. So, you could be hanging out with a group of people, and it's a mixed group of guys and girls. Again, you're not looking for relationships. But in casual conversation, if the topic of relationships does get brought up, which more than likely it will, you now have an opportunity to communicate your standards through normal conversation. So for example, if someone's talking about how men drive you crazy, or how a guy's talking about how women drive them crazy, you can be like, yeah, I totally know what you mean. I hate it when guys text all the time because they like you. Like, I get it. I want to talk to you too, but text messages just aren't my thing. I prefer phone calls. Or if you're not a phone call person, you can say that. Phone calls aren't really my thing. Text messages I much prefer. But overall, I'd love to just hang out and get to know someone. To me, that's just the best way to let someone know that you're attracted to them. And you can list some of the things that men have done in the past that drive you insane in a negative way, so that way you're communicating to just everyone in the group, namely the men, what you don't like in someone who's interested in you, what you don't want to have to deal with. And if you do that with just about every single conversation you have with men that you interact with, inevitably you're going to find a man that you're attracted to. But you're not looking for relationships, you're just looking to make friendships, and you're setting your standards. So yeah, you're attracted to this guy, you're looking to make friends, but you also kind of want to hang out with this person, right? That's what you would do if it was a friend anyway. You just happen to have feelings for this guy. You seem to be drawn and attracted to him. So by communicating this, what you're really doing is letting this person know when you're ready to attract this person, to let him know that you're attracted to him, then this is what he should do, this is what he should not do. But this is something you can tell everyone everybody. Everybody you meet in casual conversation. It's a great way to just talk to people. People like to talk about their experiences, their past relationships. People tend to bond over the things they dislike more than the things they do like. So you can definitely justify talking about behaviors of men that you dislike and then listen to behaviors of women that they dislike, which will ultimately help you decide how to further generate attraction and sparks with this individual should you choose to pursue him. Now, lastly, you've communicated your standards. This brings us to number 4. Make yourself very available for this individual while not coming off as needy in any way, shape, or form. In fact, it's going to raise your confidence and your value to this individual who you want to attract. It's important to note that men who are well-adjusted, confident, and secure with themselves are also looking for a quality partner. Because, let's face it, quality, and I mean high-quality individuals, are rare to find, whether it's a male or female. You know, the men that are out there trying to find their ideal partner, or trying to find somebody they're compatible with who are well-adjusted, are also tired of the crazy dating habits and lifestyles of today, just the way you are. So when they find someone, when they find a woman who has those same qualities, who is well-adjusted, who is secure, and who is confident with themselves, it is definitely going to leave an impression. I don't know, say a woman such as yourself, maybe? Now, when a man like that meets a woman like you, he's definitely going to be left with this sense of excitement and anticipation to get to know you, because you're a rare breed also. So with that particular realization, it's important to understand why you need to make yourself available and even handle the logistics of setting up a date. Now, what I mean by make yourself available is simply this. You're going to want to let him know what days you're available and what your schedule's like. You know, hey, we should hang out sometime. You're really awesome. I have a weird schedule. I have Wednesdays off, or maybe you have a regular schedule. Yeah, I'd love to hang out and get in touch with you over the weekend. We should definitely do something. What are some of your favorite hobbies in the world? And he's going to be like, I really like kayaking, or I've never gone kayaking, or he'll say something kind of adventurous because of how you framed the question. What are your favorite things in the world? He'll tell you things he's always wanted to do but never got a chance to do, or he'll tell you his favorite thing in the world that's also really exciting, and hopefully you guys can find something in common to allow you to set up the perfect date with this confident, self-secure, and well-adjusted man that you are now about to go on an awesome date with. Anyway, I hope this was helpful, and if you enjoyed it, please let me know. Let me know in the comment sections below. I look forward to doing more of these. Thank you so much for watching. Till next time.